Now, for me, I personally could not sleep with studs. They drove me insane, batshit crazy. I hated sleeping with studs. In today's video, we're gonna be talking about sleeping with piercings. New piercings, that is, or just if you're having problems sleeping with your piercings in general. Sleeping with piercings, I feel like, is not something people talk about a lot. Not until they're already having problems with their piercings. That's why I'm creating this video, to kind of help you guys with your piercings, because I see you guys in the comments asking, what do I do? If you guys are new, welcome to the Piercing Outlet. My name is Christina. I used to pierce ears and sell jewelry for 5 years before creating this channel. So be sure to subscribe so that way you never miss a video. And if you guys want to see some tips and tricks when it comes to sleeping with piercings, for one, give this video a thumbs up and keep on watching. Before we get into the video, first let me just say that sleeping the wrong way with your piercings can lead to your piercings getting irritated, which can further cause you to get what is called a piercing bump. Not to be confused with a keloid, the two are different. A keloid is scar tissue, a piercing bump is like an irritation bump. So if you wake up one day and your piercing is just annoying the hell out of you, it could be that maybe you slept wrong. So that's what we're going to be going over in this video, so that way we can try to avoid that as best as possible, and so that way you get peaceful nights of sleep. Now I feel like I have to include this because I do get questions about it, but yes, you still have to keep your earrings in even while you are sleeping. Definitely for the initial healing period, but after the initial healing period, up to a year, I would still keep them in while I'm sleeping, just because you do risk them closing, whether it be for an hour or 8 hours, keep them in. As soon as you take one earring out, put a new one back in right away. So sleeping in a comfortable position. Now, if you only got one ear pierced, then the obvious thing to do is sleep on the other side. But maybe that's your favorite side that you favor while you're sleeping. So in that case, I would do a few things. The first thing that you could do is just sleep on your arm without your pillow and kind of put your ear in the hole. Now, I know with me, there's no way in hell I'm doing that all night. I do not stay still at all while I'm sleeping. I would use an airplane pillow, which is just an U-shaped pillow. You can get it at Five Below. You can get them on Amazon. I'll leave a link below. And you can also use a scarf. Just roll a scarf up, make a donut out of it, and put your ear in the hole. So maybe you have multiple piercings and you don't want to really sleep on your side. You don't want to pull. What I would do is sleep in an inclined position, kind of like you're in a recliner. If you have one of those, that's going to be your best friend while you have piercings. Or you could just prop a lot of pillows up, sleep elevated, and if you really want to take it the next level, you can sleep elevated and with an airplane pillow, so that way you're not leaning on your piercings. You don't want to put any pressure on your piercings. Let me also just say that cleanliness is very important when it comes to your piercing. Always want to make sure that you have a clean surface that you're sleeping on. This goes with any type of piercing. You always want to make sure that your pillowcase is clean and fresh every single day. So if you don't want to do a lot of laundry, I do have a trick. I have a whole video on it. I'm gonna leave it at the end of this video in a little card on the side. Now for me, I personally could not sleep with studs. They drove me insane, batshit crazy. I hated sleeping with studs. So there's a few things that you can do. Now, if you're pierced at Claire's or Pierce & Magoda or Walmart, whatever, those type of places, they generally use the same two vendors. Their earring backings tend to be on the bigger side and they can be uncomfortable for some to sleep in. So after the healing period, what you can do is switch to a Libre, which has a flat backing. It's gonna be a little bit more comfortable to sleep in. The only thing with that is Libres tend to be gauged. So if you go from a regular earring to a gauge, there is going to be some discomfort when you are switching. Now, what I personally did is switch to a hoop. And there's a specific hoop that I'm going to be talking about. Now, 6 months into my piercing, I started having problems with my piercing. I got both cartilage pierced at the same time. And I just felt like the studs drove me insane. So I switched to hoops and I never looked back. Like, I've had hoops in ever since I first got them pierced, well, around 6 months later, but it's been since 2007. It's 2020 now, so I've had them pierced for, what, 13 years? Now, the type of hoop that I have has a straight post, and I would recommend them over the ones that are curved, because if the hoop that's curved isn't a big enough diameter, meaning if the hoop is not large enough, then the curve of the hoop can put pressure on your hoop and then cause a piercing bump. And that's the same thing with your nose as well. Like, if it's not big enough, then those pressure, then the curve of the actual stud can start to put pressure on your piercing, and that can also lead to a piercing bump. I know everyone is gonna be different here. It's gonna be all trial and error. So what worked for me may not work for you, but if a stud ain't working for you, then your two options are a labret or a hoop. So I'm gonna leave that video that I was mentioning earlier right here, the t-shirt video. And if you guys wanna see more piercing videos, be sure to subscribe right here. I will be back next Wednesday for another video.